They think that they want it, but they don't really want it. I strike with no warning, no, they don't see it coming. I handle my business, stay the fuck out the way. Yeah, all on my lane, get the fuck out my space. I'm on a winning streak, I'm on a winning streak. I'm on a winning streak, yeah, I'm on a winning streak. I'm on a winning streak, I'm on a winning streak.
Cardi, mi amor, nada más quería saludarte, felicitarte. Yo soy fan tuya. Perdóname que me aparecí así siempre. Óyeme, gracias por defendernos a nosotros los dominicanos. ¿Cómo te sientes de ser dominicana? ¿Me gustó la declaración que hiciste? Come on, I'm Dominican too.
Yeah, but do you see how I look?
You look beautiful.
Yeah,
but,
no,
by the way,
don't look beautiful.
Hoy es el lanzamiento de tu nuevo tema Press.
I know, but I have my daughter, I have my dad. I just don't look decent. I look how I look. Come on now, like you're a woman. No, like you come out and you look good with makeup. I don't look good. My hair's.
Come on now, don't do that to me. Okay, hold on. Señor, dígame, nunca he tenido la oportunidad de entrevistarle a usted, por lo menos. ¿Qué se siente tener una hija tan famosa?
Déjame entrar primero.
Okay.
No
pongo mago en TV.
Because my dad don't walk around with security.
Excuse me.
Excuse you.
No, muévete del medio.
No, pero muévete
tú del medio.
Don't put my father on TV because my dad don't walk around with security and you don't know people that's gonna harm my dad. Don't come to me with cameras without me knowing. That's disrespectful. I'm with my child.
La calle es libre, mi amor. La calle es libre. Baja la voz. Baja la voz. ¿Cuál es el problema? Buenas noches.
I bet you get that call back. I got a Santa Claus sack. Boy, how you handle all that? I took a chance with all that. Bitch, I'm the man with all that. A nigga try to ram with my pack. Get him that Santa Claus back. That's all red, nigga, all dead.
Welcome back to the Big Facts Podcast. I'm AO Canseco, fearless leader of AO Nation and the Men 2 Movement. And this is, we got to talk about this Cardi B shit, man. I want to talk about makeup, dog. Who in the fuck is this, dog? I gotta feel that damn hole up. Has anybody heard of this fucking, this new football league? Is this new? It's called TFL? Thundercats? Oh, the FNF. FNF on TSN. Whatever the fuck that is. Yeah, but listen, I want to talk about makeup, dog. I want to talk about makeup. We need to talk about makeup. Because makeup is, I want to talk to the ladies. I want to talk to the ladies. And I want to see what's going on with this makeup shit, man. Cardi B, as you just saw, got caught out there without her makeup on. And I just find this shit, fucking just so hypocritical, contradictory, zero self fucking awareness. First things first, let's run this shit. She said that she is not beautiful. That's really my whole shit. It just the fact that you look beautiful, you have makeup on. What the fuck does that mean? What does that mean? And to be honest, when you go and pause the clip, when she came back outside, she didn't look fucked up. She didn't look fucked up. Maybe she did have a little bit of makeup on. I would like to see her with no makeup, period. But she didn't look all the way fucked up. And that's, it shows that once you get put on this, and this is what I'm saying, like, so you on IG. So this is what's going on. The girl is on IG. Full fucking, they call that shit being beat. They face is beat. I'm not sure how the fuck that's a compliment. So they face is beat, and so here you are, and you just, so with your face being beat, you can just do the duck faces. you know, playing all the fake shit, the fake hair, fake eyes, just play all the fake shit. It's like grown children, it's like retarded people. You know what I'm saying? Because that's the only way that you would be a grown person in a grown person's body with a child's mind. A child plays in a Barbie's hair and shit like that. I'm pretty sure if you did it with a man, he does the same thing also in some senses. But this is going outside publicly. I'm hiding myself behind something that everybody knows is fake. I saw a meme today. It's so crazy. I saw this today also. It said, what's up with bitches who wear makeup all the time? It's like, when am I going to get to see you? You know what I'm saying? So a nigga is saying, like, you always wearing makeup. You always got weave in your hair. Like, am I ever going to get to see who the fuck you are? But this is what the fuck I'm talking about now. You doing all the Instagram and all the shit like this, and you know that person that you're looking back at, that person that's looking back at you when you're doing your Instagram video and shit like that, you know that that's not you. If you don't like the person that you are without this clay paste and paint on, if you don't like that person, how in the fuck are you going to go home to Offset? And this is for everybody. You going to go home to Offset, take off all that shit, wipe that shit off with all the alcohol and shit, like, and then smile at him. Like, yeah, let's get it on. The only time that you would be comfortable doing that shit is when you know that you have leverage. Listen to what the fuck I'm telling you, dog. You'll only do that when you know that you have leverage. Meaning, if he acts the wrong way, now you can go crazy. And that will be being married and or... And when I say being married, I mean you got paperwork on him. So that this slave is tagged and bagged pretty much. Because you got the slavery marriage papers on and you also have the child support looming over his head. That's when that type of shit happens. Just like a female will say that a man seems like he in the beginning he was taking me to movies, opening doors and putting his jacket over puddles and shit like that. Now he doesn't do none of that romantic shit no more. It's the same thing with females. In the beginning, you were Lauren London. I had to find somebody who don't use makeup excessively. You were Lauren London, and now you're Wendy Williams. Without makeup. Or fuck it, with makeup. You know what I'm saying? And so we both, you know, stopped trying to impress each other. Fuck it, we in love. Fuck that shit. Now you keeping it real. I'm gonna be honest with you, dog. The way that Cardi B looked, as far as her dress, the way she was dressed, it looked like she hadn't bathed. I'm gonna be honest with you, dog. That looked like, and maybe that was the fucking point. Like, I don't want to go out looking like somebody and shit like that. If I go too crazy and shit like that, I look too good and everybody will look at me and shit like that. I just want to be ducked off today. But she had on fucking Lord. And it's crazy. I'm saying that because this is how the average fucking female looks, and this is why. I tell motherfucker, dog, if Jocelyn Hernandez came to the club, niggas would be like, what the fuck? You know what I'm saying? Because they haven't seen a bitch get that dolled up before. And because that costs more money. You understand? A bitch in a small city get the bitches call a BBL. They'll get the Brazilian butt lift, which means they gonna cut, they have an operation, they cut their stomach and take the contents of their stomach and put it in the ass instead of taking the contents of their stomach and throwing that shit away and starting off with a new body. No. I want to keep the fat. Just put it in my ass. can't really get mad at it. You know what I'm saying? It seemed weird as fuck, but for some reason, it just, I don't know, it just make it easier to bust. But at, like I'm saying, though, dog, all that shit gets old, dog. All that shit, I'm saying it like, I'm kind of confused because it's like, that shit, it seemed like it feel better fucking a hoe with a fat ass because it just seemed like it give your dick like a better home. You know what I'm saying? It's like a better home for your dick, whatever like that, than with a hoe just with like a, I mean, it could go either way. I mean, especially when you fucking a missionary, you wouldn't really know. You can grab that. I mean, it's like, it's just, it, that's all it is. It's just like a, like a stress ball. You know what I'm saying? It is because you can pretend what you pretending is. I'm pretending that what I'm squeezing is what I'm fucking, when that's not the case. But it kind of feels like it, though. You know what I'm saying? This soft. You know what I'm saying? That's what, so I'm squeezing. You know what I'm saying? And I'm using this as a grip. You know what I'm saying? But you can use a grip either way. But so it's crazy, dog. But what I'm saying is that this alone will not make or break a relationship. It will maybe make or break a first night or a nigga what you want. A nigga spending money. You know what I'm saying? You trying to get you a gaggle of fucking ducks, meaning a group of ducks. Maybe that's geese. You want a gaggle of ducks. And as I'm thinking about it, this is what, y'all go check out my nigga, dog. It's an artist out of fucking Danville, Virginia. His name is King Gems. And this nigga has a song so fucking live, dog. And he speaks about this shit like he actually goes, and I can fuck with niggas who talk about the shit that I like, the shit that I know. Like a nigga, you rapping about some shit that I can tell by the way you rap that you done been through the same shit I've been through. I can tell that you not no duck ass nigga. Like you're not just saying bitch and hoe because it's cool to say bitch and hoe, but you would never call a bitch or a hoe to their face. This nigga, dog, and he got a lot of songs like that. Just go fuck with King Gems, Black Diamond. I'm gonna put this shit in the description box and shit like that. Fuck with that dude, dog. And we need more artists like that on not on the R&B tip, but just on the rap tip that go deeper into street relationships. Bitch, if what you trying to do is get you a gaggle of ducks, get you more than one duck with that body, and you just trying to use that body to make money, which is prostitution, either way you put it, then that's cool. And but just understand that's the way you will be treated. If you're leading with the back, you're backwards, and it's already throwed the fuck off. You know what I'm saying? Like, so just understand it. Like, if you've done the surgery, you're a nothing ass bitch. Huh? If you've had a BBL, if you've had a ass injections, titty shit, all that shit like that, if you wouldn't go outside and work that shit yourself, you're a nothing ass bitch. I'm just being honest. I don't have no respect for no bitch that goes to a doctor. And you got bitches like Black China. You got bitches like Black China that go on the Breakfast Club. I don't see anything wrong with even fucking Jada Pickett said that shit, man. But let's go back. I'm going too far. The way Cardi B looked, as far as just like, it's like, so you couldn't do shit with that hair, I guess, because it's not yours. I mean, it just looks raggedy. It just looks raggedy. The pants, and you can tell a hoe with real ass, dog. That ass did not move. It's a big block ass. You know what I'm saying? Just a big ass block. You know what I'm saying? Like a big ass TV. You know what I'm saying? Like, ho, you might be must. I'm telling you, dog. I'm telling you. I like, when you fuck with enough hoes, you can tell, like, what kind of, like, ho, that shit posed a move when you walk. That shit was stiff as a motherfucker as she was walking. And it's like, you can take the hood rat out the hood, but you cannot take that shit out of more. Like, you can't do it. See, that's the difference between working at McDonald's for 12 years to get what you want, and then, you know, getting in, running out in front of a truck and getting hit and just being given the money. The motherfucker that worked for that goddamn money is going to pace it. So now if they do get a settlement, they'll pace it. The motherfucker who just out this motherfucker trying to get hurt by somebody so they can sue somebody, it'll never be enough. Cardi B first got her titties done because her body was her business. She was a prostitute, aka stripper, same thing. Her body is what made her money. So let me go ahead and get, if just like if you're you race cars and shit like that, I gotta put some more money into my engine so that I can win more races. This is my source of income. That was the first thing she did. Then she come. Then we just find out about Juju did the same shit. And you love. And I'm telling you, dog, I'm gonna be honest with you, dog. It's just, I don't know. This just a nigga mind. Just ignorance. But for some reason, dog, when you see a dark skin, let me try to go through my mind and make sure I'm not gonna be instantaneously wrong. I at least let me be wrong in the comment section. When you see a dark skin girl with a body, 9 times out of 10, you believe that that's actually her body. I thought that Juju was a natural. So that was news to me that she wasn't. I don't know. Not to say that light-skinned hoes ain't built like that. Because, of course, we know light-skinned hoes, they got stupid ass. But it's just like, you don't... Seem like I should know a dark-skinned girl who didn't had the operation and shit like that in Hollywood. But it just really seemed like you see more dark-skinned girls that are natural, that naturally have ass and they actually built like that. Because the closer you are to the source, the more melanin you have, the more, that's the further you are away from the European thing. You know what I'm saying? The European thing is the European thing. The African thing is the African thing. We'll just leave it just like that. But back into it, the main thing about this whole shit is, if you have to be embarrassed about the way you naturally or almost naturally look, you can't go outside without this mask on, then what the fuck are you? What are you? I don't want to be seen with my face. Then are you famous? Or is this mask famous? Do niggas like you? Or do they like the mask that you always put on Instagram? And I thought that was just such a revealing moment. And I just had to do it. I had to speak on it because it just, it proved everything. That this makeup shit is truly, she said it on camera, I'm not beautiful. I'm not beautiful. And that was with a wig on. So you see how closely, or the similarities between the drugs and this weave and makeup shit. At first, you know what I'm saying? All you need is one pill. All you need is one blunt. All you need is one set. One rock. Whatever the fuck it is. At first, all you need is eyeliner. Then you need two blunts, two rocks, two pills. Now you need eyeliner and motherfucking a foundation. Up and up. Eyeliner, weave, foundation. And it just keep going up. And then now you don't want to be around people unless you have your tolerance level. So now if you don't have 5 blunts, you don't even want to be seen in public. If you don't got a weave, foundation, eyeshadow, just all this shit, you don't feel like yourself. And that's what I'm saying. If there's anyone, any girl who's, you know, you on, but I mean, if you're on Instagram and you're an Instagram model, it's already too late. But if you're trying to be this Instagram model, natural beauty is always going to win, because the natural beauty, and this is another reason why I don't like the weave shit, because the natural beauty will always beat a Cardi B. Lauren London will always beat, she'll always have something over her, because she can always go on here barefaced. Barefaced. And just do the same thing that you have to make a whole, you got to mix all these different shits. You got to have $1 million worth of fucking makeup to do what she does naturally. And this is the same way I feel about this weave shit. How can you get on this bitch and flex and floss and all this other shit? And then here come a white girl. Here come a Brazilian girl. And just all these other races that don't have to tie their hair down and hide their shit. But just to be fucking seen in public, you gotta tie your shit down and put a bag over your shit. How does that seem like right? That's not logical. That makes no fucking sense. You're obviously saying, I do not look good without this, because we never see you without it, whatever the fuck it may be. And you know, image is a big thing for it. But you know, you can't say that image is a big thing or beauty is a big thing for women, because if it was, then you would believe in true beauty, which wouldn't be going to the doctor and slicing this, opening that, all this other shit like this. You would believe, I have to go to the gym every morning. I have a fucking regimen. If sex was that big, sex is a big thing for women, you would go to any sex class, any seduction class that they had, and make sure that you're the first, like, let me make sure I can please a man. If cooking was a big thing for women, you would make sure that you was in every cookbook. Instead of looking at Love and Hip Hop, you'll be looking at, all right, this is how you make a shrimp flambé. Oh, okay. And I practiced this for years. The same amount of time that I've watched drama on TV with reality TV shows, I've done way more study on cleanliness, cooking, cleaning, sex, and keeping my body right, naturally. Because beauty is big for a woman, cleanliness is big for a woman, cooking is big for a woman, and being good in the bedroom is big for a woman. You wouldn't try to substitute these things with all this fucking cosmetic shit that doesn't matter in the fucking bedroom. Because with all the ass shots, with all the fucking makeup, which is pretty much all you can do, you can still be a horrible fucking cook. And believe it or not, you can be horrible at giving head, as Blac Chyna, and horrible at sex itself. Ask every one of these bitches who has ass shots and all this shit and still get cheated on for a hood rat. These things are not going to bring happiness, and that's all that should be spoken on right here. These things will not bring happiness. In fact, the same as dope, they'll bring sadness. Imagine having to hide your natural face because you know that you've been lying to the people. No, don't look at me yet. Don't look at me. I don't have my filters. Go to go anywhere. Just go outside where people are at and goddamn put a camera on the bitch and see how they run. They've gotten so used to these filters. Today's the day you finna go get your hair done, put your weave in. Today, do the fucking contouring, do your eye, whatever the fuck it is. And you have to pay somebody, you gotta pay somebody else to do it because you just not comfortable with it. Just think. When's the last time you put a camera on a guy? Or even a white girl? Or another race? and they start hiding like this because they can't live without filters. Don't, please do not pick out one race. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't fucking do it. Change, fix the problem. Don't do semantics.
Oh, you can't find a white girl who...
Please. Please. You know that you do not feel comfortable with people seeing you without this, 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 and this. And this is what I'm saying. I go on your page and all there is just pictures, pictures, pictures. Yeah, ain't pictures, pictures. So I would assume that me coming anywhere and taking a picture of you, you would love the shit. But no, no, no. How many hours do you spend photoshopping your shit? To where when a person sees you in real life, you have to hide. A lot of y'all can't laugh at Cardi B. A lot of y'all cannot laugh at Cardi B. But let this be a fucking example. Where you thought makeup was the biggest part of this whole thing. Makeup. You look beautiful. You have makeup. And of course, they do this on TV. But why are they doing this on TV? Why is it wrong to be natural on TV? Do they want you to feel like you're not beautiful? Do they want you to feel like this is the standard of beauty and this is where you sit? And then right after they show you the show with all people with all the makeup, they give you a fucking makeup commercial. A lipstick commercial. Maybelline, L'Oreal. People that don't even wear makeup know this shit. Maybe she's born with it. But then at the same fucking time, they'll tell you everyone's beautiful in their own way. You know it's bullshit. You know it's bullshit. You don't believe that. Cardi B, how the fuck can she tell her fans, all of y'all are beautiful? You're all beautiful. How does that make you feel? Knowing that she doesn't mean it. Does it matter at all? Or do you just take it at face value, it's all good? This is what's really going on. This is real life. I'm just so glad that we have a celebrity example of it. Because this, it's been so many times where I might be shooting some here, shooting some there. And a bitch will be all with, look what he's doing. But as soon as the camera come around, these hoes start running to the back of the store. Oh, no, don't put me on camera. Oh, no, I got a stalker. I'm not going to say nothing smart right there. I'm not going to make no joke right there. I'm just going to leave it just like it is. You got a stalker, though? You? All right. I'm just saying, let's go by what we say, man. If we believe that this is beautiful, let's just have one... Let's know what beauty is. If we're going to say it, let's mean what the fuck we say. Obviously, this shit has been debunked. She does not feel like you can be beautiful. Well, she can't be beautiful. And then, knowing that she feels that way, how do you think she feels about natural beauties? Like Lauren London. Like this one, that one, this one. How do you think she feels about them? When she has to take hours... before even coming outside. What's gonna happen? Dog, I seen a picture of Kimora Lee Simmons. And she has fallen off so fucking bad, dog. Cause I saw because she's letting the nigga from Blood Diamond, his child, she got a child with him. I think Katrina told me. Subscribe to Conversation With Me, Katrina Gibbs. Katrina told me she got like 4 or 5 kids and shit like that. For every nigga she's been in a relationship with, she's had a child by them. So she don't give a fuck about Baby Fat. But she said Baby Fat is coming back. I should know that, but that's what happens when you have girlfriends. I recant that statement. I have female friends. I have one female friend. Actually, no, I have female friends. I have more than one female friend. You know, when I was young and shit like that, I felt like the only niggas who can be friends with girls and shit like that, like, not have sex. Like, why would you be friends with a girl and not have sex with them? Thought that, like, gay niggas and shit. But then when you start doing business and shit, like, you don't want to do that. You don't want to put no sex in between none of that shit, dog. It's going to fuck a lot. It'll fuck up a lot of good shit. Because relationships, even, it doesn't matter what the fuck. Like, once you put sex in the mix, you put a time limit on it. The clock starts. As soon as sex happens, the clock starts. The fucking clock starts. To where some bullshit happens and now we can't do it. I can't stand that motherfucker. The clock starts. As soon as you have sex with someone, the fucking clock starts. And you can try to extend the fucking timeline and shit like that, but the shit's gonna blow up. Because one day, you just not gonna feel like doing what you have to do to extend the time anymore. Because it's work. Like, if you got a fuse, you just lit a TNT fuse and shit like that. You might, oh, we gotta make this shit last longer. Oh. It's gonna be work to do that shit though. When fuck that shit. Let that shit go. I'm not finna keep on trying to make this goddamn thing not end. Fuck this shit. And that's relationships. But that's what I want to talk to y'all about. This fucking makeup. Y'all let me know if I'm, you know what I'm saying, throwed off about this shit. And how do you feel about dating someone with makeup? Let's just do makeup. We ain't gonna go into the weave shit. Let's just do makeup. How do you feel about a girl who wears makeup? Do you feel like if she wears makeup on a first date that she's hiding something? Being that that's the same thing that a tranny would do. I'm here to date a woman. I want to know if we're going to get anywhere in this relationship, I need to know what the fuck you look like. Why does looks matter? If looks don't matter, then why in the fuck would you wear makeup? Why wouldn't you come just straight from the gym? This is me on my worst day, which is that's how the fuck I feel. I feel like you should see what a person looks like when they lie, see what a person looks like when they cry, and see what a person looks like when they get mad in the beginning, so you can see whether or not this is somebody that you can fuck with on their worst day, not their best day. Because you only, how often do you have your best day? Usually it's a whole bunch of, you know what I'm saying, you got, if you lucky, you'll have a, Lord, if you lucky, you'll have 6 days of average and fucked up days, and one, hopefully, you'll have one day where it's, oh, everything is all good. And that day is usually Friday. But y'all let me know about that shit. Big Facts Podcast. Make sure I hit the PayPal. I see y'all in a minute. Love.